G'day and welcome to Mark and Sam After Work. Today I want to do a video a little bit to help with answering some questions I get from a lot of new shooters and people who are asking stuff that there's a little bit that I can help with. probably more so actually about our gun community, and be that the Second Amendment in the US side of things, or in us, all around the world, to be truthful, and something that it does, the more I think about it, it goes to that place. So what I'm actually talking about is gun clubs and gun communities, and how much of a particularly something like what we do, the ELR stuff, and the way we do things, we're stuck by ourselves, our gun interaction is, apart from I've got some handguns and different things in front of me, which I'll explain in a little minute, where we do go to clubs for that sort of stuff. But for our ELR stuff and what people want to learn a lot from us and ask questions, it's a bit more of a out there by yourself in the bush side of things, which is, listen, although I suppose great for the industry, it's a good personal challenge, and all those things are really, really important, which I would always stress about anyone curious about guns and shooting and this sport, is that yes, it can be very challenging, very rewarding, really nice, really great way, certainly the way we do it with me and Sam, you know, the team building, the experience together, it's very much because of us, I chose to do this, we chose to do this, but it also is just very rewarding. But let's, the gun community conversation, which I was actually talking about, the club side of things is very, very valuable, and I would recommend to anyone that has a choice to be involved, both for your own sake, both for certainly new shooters and that sort of stuff. Find yourself a club and be a member of that club to help with our community. The more people we've got doing, the more people that are over on this side, the more people, or the less people that are frightened of guns. And yes, all over the world, that's no matter what your country is, there are people frightened of guns. In some cases, they'll have valid reasons. In other cases, it's just Hollywood and the media and the politicians doing their thing to make sure that happens. The best way, in my opinion at least, to stop that, to change that, is to get more people involved.
And clubs are the best place to do that.
The likes of me and Sam out in the bush doing our thing. It's actually a very small percentage, very, very small percentage of the world. The large percentage of the world are in cities, in metropolises, in large areas, in large built-up areas, where the real connection they can have in a positive way is in the gun clubs and the gun communities. So the more of the straight shooters, the more of the genuine folks, the more we can connect that, the more we can make that a positive thing, the better it is. That's the best way to deal with this. Make it so it's not a scary thing. And listen, introduce other people to the fun of this thing. But what I come back to is for our new shooters, for people who want to know stuff, want to know more bits and pieces, the best way to do this is alongside other people, is alongside people where both the nature of that sort of thing is we learn by other people, other people's mistakes, triumphs, successes, figuring out, and by our own, and they learn by us. But also we can help with the correct way of doing things. Now, the correct way of doing things isn't necessarily one way of doing things. It isn't necessarily out of the handbook. It does mean common sense involved. It does mean safety's involved. Not a big safety person, but I like to do things done the smart, common sense, safe way. So there is lots of that sort of stuff, and understanding those processes makes it better for everybody. I have these firearms in front of us to say that although people, a lot of misinformation about Australia's gun laws. Now, I'm not going to go into Australia's gun laws, but our clubs are a huge part of our laws. Things like this, which is my Gold Cup 45 ACP, is legal, and I have a few handguns. I have to go to the club and use this. A great firearm, love using it. I'm nowhere near as skilled with a handgun as I am with a rifle, but it's still lots and lots of fun to use this thing. Sam's 686, she's pretty good with this little fella, and something that, once again, people wouldn't realize. This is also, we've both got one of these, but this is Sam's pump action shotgun. the Remington 870. And then, listen, there's a cupboard full of that sort of stuff. We use the likes of the ones I've got here. Specifically, we can have them because we use them at the range. Now, our laws are a little weird, a little down their road, where we can't use them elsewhere. We have to use them at the range, but we still own them and we keep them here. There's all the negatives that I've no doubt lots of people see in that side of things, and I understand that you can't do this and can't do that and all that sort of stuff. Yes, that is a part of the world we live in. But there's also some real positives to the fact that we do have to go to the range, and we do are a part of a community, and we get to help other people do their thing as well. I certainly know people that have now shoot probably something similar, or whether it's a Tanfoglio or it's a whatever it is in the way of a target semi-automatic handgun, that's what they are. Competition guys, they do really well on the competition side of things, and these are people that didn't even know that there were firearms in Australia to any level as little as 5 years ago. And with a couple of years of being around a mate and going to a range, and then they find they can do it, and then they get licensed, and we're talking 2 or 3 years later, they're good at the competition because they're practicing and training, and it actually is a real thing in part of dealing with our modern world. And I'm not talking about picking up weapons to fight the world, not at all. I'm talking about like any good enthusiast where you've got a passion to go and do to get better at, makes your whole life better if you are then got something to get onto. And they are something that there is a lot more access all over the world than we realize. And if there's not access, it is generally a possible thing to go through and do. You get a group of people to go down that road and build yourself a club and get more community people into the community, which is really where I'm coming from. The more, as said previously, the best way to fight the people coming for the guns is by the more people have them and are using them in a responsible, enthusiastic way, the less fear that goes with it, the less power that the other side has. So, listen, a little bit political, don't really want to go there. Not something I touch on much. Once again, being in clubs and that side of things, it isn't where I take the video side of things. My stuff is precision rifle and what I put forward, but I really would like to encourage as many of the gun community or the people that are thinking about this sort of stuff, and certainly the new shooters, that sort of stuff, to get yourself involved with the club. You know, if you are an Aussie, yeah, you can be shooting a semi-automatic handgun and having fun with that on every second weekend or whatever your club can do, which is a good skill to gain. I would come back to my feeling on skill building is not just one thing, not just the muscle memory for one thing. Diversity really helps the one thing as well. Anyway, guys, that's enough for my little rant about that one there. Get involved with the club if you can. Build this community, make us strong. Yeah, and thanks for checking in on us. We'll catch you next time.